Now that we've learned Ohm's law, as well as the two Kirchhoff's rules, specifically the junction rule and the loop rule, we need to learn about one more concept, that of equivalent resistance, that will then allow us to analyze basically any circuit involving resistors, no matter how simple or how complicated. So let's first discuss what exactly equivalent resistance is. Let's say I had a circuit like this, where I have some voltage across the battery, and I've got some, you know, various combination of resistors. I've got a couple in parallel, a couple in series, etc. And the total current through this circuit, aka the current that is leaving the battery from the positive end and going into the battery into the negative end, would be some, you know, current I. And the thing is that if I took out all of these resistors and replaced it with another resistor that resulted in the same current being drawn from the battery, well then ultimately this circuit is going to behave in a lot of ways exactly the same. Well, how exactly do we know how big this resistance here needs to be? And well, that resistance is known as the equivalent resistance. It is the resistance of a single resistor that can be substituted in for a combination of resistors because its resistance is equivalent to their combination. But so therefore it still results in the same current being pulled from the battery. So let's start off with a series combination of resistors, reminding ourselves what that means, that a series combination is when all the circuit elements are part of the same loop with the battery. So I have this battery here connected to R1, which is in series with R2, which is in series with R3. And let's remember what Kirchhoff's rules tell us. Well, first off, the junction rule tells us that since there's no junctions in this circuit, that the same current is going to be flowing through each resistor. It's going to be the same current that's leaving and entering the battery. And additionally, looking at Kirchhoff's loop rule, we know that since there's only a singular loop here, that the voltage of the battery is equal in magnitude to the voltage across each of these three resistors added together. So delta V1 plus delta V2 plus delta V3 equals the voltage across the battery. Now, let's pause there for a second and say, okay, what are we trying to do? We want to know what is the equivalent resistance of these three resistors in series. So ultimately, I want to know what size resistor do I need to put in by itself to match the resistance of these three combined? Well, let's see how exactly we would do that. But let's actually start with this loop rule up here, that the voltage of the battery is equal to the sum of the three voltages across the resistors. And let's remind ourselves that Ohm's law tells us that the current is equal to delta V over R. So therefore, if I multiply this R across, the voltage across any piece of this circuit is going to equal to the current times the resistance. So for delta V1, that is the current times the resistance R1. For delta V2, IR2. For delta V3, IR3. Now let's talk about what I did over here on the left-hand side. Well, that's the voltage of the battery, and that is the total current of this circuit. Well, how would we solve for that total current? Well, I would say, well, it's got I is equal to delta V of the battery over the entire resistance of the circuit. So this R is actually the equivalent resistance of this series combination. And what we notice is, well, I've got an I, a current that's exactly the same in all of these terms, so I can just divide through by I, and I am left with a fairly straightforward equation for the equivalent resistance. That's simply equal to the summation of these resistances of the individual resistors. And in fact, that is the equation for the equivalent resistance. So if I want to know the equivalent resistance of a series combination, I just add up all the resistances of the individual resistors. R1 plus R2 plus no matter how many resistors there are, all the way up to whatever number Ri. So if I had 10 resistors, this would be all the way to R10, 12 resistors all the way to R12, etc. Now this is written in this form, I believe on your equation sheet, basically saying that the series combination is equal to, remember the sigma just means sum, so ultimately it's just telling me it's the sum of the individual resistors all the way from the first one to however many you have. Now, one thing to note here is that because we are combining all of these resistances together, that tells me that if we add more and more resistors in series, we are going to increase the total resistance of the circuit. But since the voltage of the battery doesn't change, if we're increasing that total resistance, that means the total current will go down as we add more and more resistors in series. Now let's look at a parallel combination, reminding ourselves what parallel means, that essentially every circuit element is in its own loop. And this is a very simplistic parallel circuit. So I've got a battery that has one resistor R1 connected in parallel to this resistor R2 connected in parallel to this resistor R3. So I have like one loop here, for instance, one loop going all the way through this one and one loop going all the way through that one. And let's go ahead and once again use Kirchhoff's rules to remind ourselves how exactly we can analyze the different pieces here. Well, first off, we know that the current, the total current leaving and entering the battery, splits between these three branches. So we're going to get I1 plus I2 plus I3 will be the total current. Additionally, we know that since each of these is in its own loop with the battery, that the voltage across each of these resistors is one, the same, and two, equal to the voltage of the battery. So now let's say, all right, well, I want to replace these three resistors that are in parallel with a single resistor that will allow the total current to remain the same. So this would be the equivalent resistance of this parallel combination. Well, how exactly would I go about doing that? Well, instead of starting with the loop rule, let's actually start with the current or the junction rule, saying that the total current leaving and entering the battery is equal to these individual currents through the three branches, I1 plus I2 plus I3. Let's remind ourselves, okay, well, I can use Ohm's law for all four of these pieces. So I have that I1 is equal to the voltage across R1 divided by the resistance R1. I've got I2 is divided by the voltage delta V all over R2, etc. And additionally, the total current is equal to the voltage of the battery over the resistance of this entire combination. And looking at this, once again, we can simplify because I can divide each piece by delta V, and that ends up with having something that looks like this, which looks a little bizarre, but this is actually what the equation is going to look like. Specifically, that the equivalent resistance of a parallel combination is equal to, and let's be careful, 1 over this equivalent parallel resistance is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3 plus etc, 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 until we get to 1 over Ri. And on your equation sheet, you will see it written like this, where 1 over this equivalent resistance in parallel is equal to the summation of all of these 1 over pieces. Now, the thing that's really tricky here is that it's perfectly fine to be able to add all up 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2, but it's extremely easy to forget that after you add all of these together, you have to take the inverse to get the equivalent resistance by itself, because currently it is 1 over. And I find that, typically speaking, we really easily forget that. So there's actually a different way that we can write it that I think is more useful, particularly because it's a lot quicker to punch it into your calculator. So instead, I'm going to actually write it like this, that the equivalent resistance of this parallel combination is equal to R1 to the minus 1 power, keeping in mind that that's the same thing as 1 over R1. Keep in mind there's also a minus 1 key in your calculator. So I can put in that number to the minus 1, plus the next number to the minus 1, plus the next number to the minus 1, and then at the end, take the minus 1 of the whole thing. Ultimately, in other words, saying I'm taking the inverse of that entire summation of all those individual inverses. Now, one thing that's not quite as obvious here as it was in the previous one is that if we add more and more resistors in parallel, what we actually end up doing is decreasing the overall equivalent resistance of this circuit. And if we decrease the overall resistance and the voltage of the battery stays the same, that means that the current is actually going to increase as we add more and more and more branches. So let's kind of see something like this in practice so we can see how exactly we would go about utilizing it. So let's say I want to determine the current through each resistor in this circuit. I have a 30-volt battery, and I know that all four of these resistors, 1, 2, 3, and 4, are 2 ohms, 4 ohms, 12 ohms, and 5 ohms, where 2 and 3 are in parallel, and they're both, that combination is connected in series to the other two. And if I look at this, I definitely don't have enough information at this current moment in time to utilize Kirchhoff's junction rule, because I have no currents on here at all, or the loop rule, because I don't know any of the currents, so I can't figure out the voltages. In addition, I can't use Ohm's law, because I don't know what this combination is. So the first thing that, honestly, you're going to want to do with most of these complicated circuits immediately is figure out the equivalent resistance of the entire circuit. Now, you're going to notice here, though, that I've got some parts in series and some parts in parallel. So my best advice for this is to look at the circuit, focus in on a small piece of it that's like self-contained, and then when you find the equivalent resistance of that small piece, then expand outward to a next bigger piece. When you find that equivalent resistance, expand outward again, and kind of zoom out as you go. So for instance, looking here, what is a small piece I could focus in on? Well, I could focus in on this parallel combination of the 4 ohm and 12 ohm resistor. So I'm going to find the parallel equivalent resistance of those two resistors. So I'm going to utilize this equation, that this equivalent resistance is R2 to the minus 1, so the 4 to the minus 1, plus 12 to the minus 1. I take the minus 1 of the whole thing and get an equivalent resistance of that combination of 3 ohms, which makes sense, because the resistance should go down when they are in parallel. So I can substitute that in here. So now I have 2 ohms, 3 ohms. I basically replaced these two with this resistor and 5 ohms. Well, now this is a pretty straightforward series combination. So I can just add these three resistances together, and 2 plus 3 plus 5 gives me a total equivalent resistance of 10 ohms. Well, why exactly is that useful? Well, if I know that the total equivalent resistance is 10 ohms, I know that the voltage of this battery is 30 volts, then I can use Ohm's law and say, okay, 30 divided by 10, well, that's 3 amps. But the thing is that this equivalent resistance was identical to this combination of resistors we had originally, meaning that how much current must be leaving this 30-volt battery and entering it in this particular scenario here? 3 amps. Automatically, we already know the current through resistor 1 and resistor 4 because they're connected in series of the batteries. There's no junctions there, so all of the current must go through those. So I know that both of those must have 3 amps of current. Well, then we look at this parallel combination and go, okay, well, how exactly is the current going to split here? And let's think about Kirchhoff's rules. One, I can't use the junction rule yet because I don't really know how much current's going to go one way or the other. But what I can use is I can use Kirchhoff's loop rule. Keeping in mind that since I know the currents in 1 and 4, I can figure out the voltages across 1 and 4 using Ohm's law. So in the 1 resistor, resistor 1, I've got a current of 3 amps times its resistance of 2 ohms, meaning that the voltage drop across this one is 6 volts. And this one over here, I have its current of 3 amps times its resistor of 5 ohms, gives me a voltage of 15 ohms. And therefore, if this is 6, and this is 15, and this whole thing in each loop has to match 30, that tells me that the voltage across this branch and the voltage across this branch each must be 30 minus 6 minus 15, which is 9 volts. So this branch must have 9 volts across it, and this branch, 3, must also have 9 volts across it. But if I know the voltages across both of those branches and I know their resistances, then I can now just use Ohm's law. And in fact, I'm going to do that. For the second resistor, I'm going to do its voltage of 9 volts divided by its resistance of 4 ohms, and I get 2.25 amps. And then in the third resistor, the 12 ohm one, I get, what is it, 9 divided by 12, or 0.75 amps. And we know that this works out because 2.25 plus 0.75 amps gives me 3 amps, meaning that the junction rule is obeyed. And now I have the current through each of these 4 resistors. So now I have essentially multiple tools. I've got Ohm's law, I've got the junction rule, I've got the loop rule, and I've got the ability to make equivalent resistances of series and parallel combinations. So what are the main takeaways for this video on equivalent resistance? Well, one, can we determine the equivalent resistance of some series combination of resistors, some parallel combination of resistors, or some combination of the two? And additionally, can we utilize equivalent resistance of a circuit as a whole in order to analyze specific components? Keeping in mind that if we know the voltage of the battery and the equivalent resistance of the entire circuit, we know the current that must be the total current in that circuit.